Mr. President, may I present Kovi to you?
You have 15 minutes.
To the President, off you go. I'll stop you if it goes over. Yeah.
Perfect. Yesterday you gave a speech in Strasbourg, now we are sitting here in Brussels, which basically marks the first topic I would like to discuss with you, which is moving of the European Parliament between Strasbourg and Brussels. Yesterday you said, and I quote, "I want Europe to become the leader when it comes to the fight against climate change." But this moving itself, it causes around 10,000 tons of CO2, and it's incredibly expensive. According to recent studies, around 100 million euros per year. So why is this still a thing?
Because this is the consequence of European history. Strasbourg is a city located in France, but very close to Germany, the Rhine River, which is the most dramatic and tragic river in Europe, was witnessing so many conflicts, and the fact that the European Parliament, the symbol of the European democracy, is meeting in Strasbourg is meaningful. The Council of Europe, 48, 49 countries, they are there, and the European Union has to have its place there. So I know that this is costly, but history is always costly.
So you think we should pay that much for the symbol and taxpayers should pay this cost?
Taxpayers can't escape to the consequences of history.
All right. That was pretty strong. Okay. I think not only young people struggle to make a point where when I ask them, for example, about something positive about being a member of European Union, I also hear about peace, I hear about trade, Schengen area, and cancelled roaming, but I hear much more of a criticism when it comes to a different kind of regulations, and the fact that EU is sometimes not really flexible and fast when it comes to hard decisions or hard issues. So, what do you think is a problem that not only young people, but European citizens mostly see disadvantages or problems instead of positive things that are happening?
I think that's quite normal. Disadvantages are easy to be described. Advantages have to be proved. I would like to invite those who are skeptical, and skepticism is accepted, admitted, we have to deal with the arguments of those who are reluctant when it comes to European integration. We have to ask people if they would prefer to live on a continent which would be divided, where countries would be dramatically separated, where the freedom of movement would not exist, or if they prefer to live in this European Union. One